you know, sometimes one of you writes to us about something small that turns into something much bigger.
Just like the socks that a North Canterbury sheep farmer got in touch with us about. Garth explains why.
Once upon a time, you said New Zealand, people said,
whoa.
This is Marina Shearer, great name for a sheep farmer.
Little heart's beating. Oh.
This one's just a few days old, and I'm feeling all warm and fuzzy, Marina might say, just like wool itself.
If you're talking about sustainability, wool. If you're talking about reliability, wool. If you're talking about the New Zealand story, wool.
This is Fair Go, not Country Calendar. So you know, someone says they're getting fleeced.
We've been taken over by a synthetic story. It's not who we are. And we're being tricked.
By things like these socks.
My eye caught a lamb photo, a sheep, lamb, green pasture of New Zealand on a pair of socks. And I thought, that's odd. Those socks don't really look like wool socks.
And the breakdown mentions no wool.
Absolutely misleading. Absolutely.
She'd have turned a blind eye if wool was doing well. But take a look at this.
What's all this?
This is our latest wool clip that we're holding in storage here because it's not worth sending it into town to the auction.
So what do you see when you look around here?
Oh, I see a tragedy. I just think it's such a tragedy to see this wool banked up here. And it's not just banked up in our farm, it's banked up in farms all over New Zealand.
This is strong wool, crossbred, not merino, good for carpets, outerwear, and going nowhere. The price now wouldn't even cover the cost of shearing.
So you lose a dollar
every time? We lose a dollar every time we shear a sheep.
That's news to most of us.
Oh, really? Okay.
And also to the importer of those socks we mentioned.
So is there any wool in the socks?
No wool.
Well, if there's no wool in the socks, why have you got a picture of sheep and a lamb?
Because that's New Zealand. We do a lot of New Zealand souvenirs.
Does he sound a bit sheepish?
It's the photo make people misunderstanding. Maybe we need to take the picture off.
Round one to Marina. Next.
Let's talk about fleece.
Yeah.
Okay. That on that sheep is a fleece. The polar fleece is not a fleece. That's a man-made product. Why not call them something else? Why not call them what they are? Fluffy acrylic.
She's not done.
There's products called glass wool and earth wool are also not wool products.
Harder. Fleece isn't a trademark. Heaps of clothing companies use it. And the earth wool people say, what about cotton wool or steel wool? They call their glass wool earth wool because it's brown and made with recycled glass. So, is the fight for wool done or just begun?
Marina should have got really upset by that. You know, for too long we've just taken this.
John has helped fetch a fine price for fine merino wool. Now he wants the best for the rest of the flock.
Battleground's also been fought for the conscious consumer who needs to be aware of what she's in fact buying. And a natural product is just so superior.
He likes some radical changes.
Putting warning labels on synthetic garments because of how much damage that they do to the environment and also because of the potential of microplastics.
At the very least, he wants us to give our wool industry the credit it deserves.
We've just got to wrap the story around it and connect to those consumers and be given a fair go with regard to other people coming in and passing off on our product.
I did say once upon a time at the start, Marina's fairy tale ending, that's up to all of us.
Look, respectfully, if you're buying woolen socks and they're like $4, you may want to look on the back and see if they're actually made of wool. I think it's also up to the consumer a wee bit to toe the line.
Still, I don't think these things should be misleading.
True.